everybody. I'm Ken Bradley, and welcome once again to All-Star Professional Wrestling. Indeed, we're going to have some extremely exciting matches on hand for you today. We're going to be having a newcomer, Ted Norris, going up against Bounty Hunter number one. Tracy Richards will be facing Natasha in a special ladies match. Mike Prather will be going up against Jerry Graham. And Abner Collins and Danny Roberts will be facing the team of the Masked Assassins. Certainly an hour ahead that I'm sure will be exciting to all of you. And of course, later in the program, we're going to be talking with Dr. Jerry Graham, needless to say, a very controversial individual indeed. But right now it's time for our first match, so let's go into the ring with our ring announcer, Jeff Funk.
Hi, good afternoon, and welcome to All-Star Professional Wrestling. For our referee for this hour will be Rocky Montana. And a corner to my right, weighing 225 pounds, from Las Vegas, Nevada, Ted Norris. And a corner to my left, with his manager, Mr. B, Bounty Hunter number one.
Well, there you have it. Ted Norris going up against Bounty Hunter number one. And the Bounty Hunter, of course, managed by Mr. B, a controversial individual. And there you see Mr. B exiting the ring. I hope to have a talk with Mr. B a little later on in the program. I'd like to find out some information from him. Both men, of course, squaring off at this time. There you see Chuck Morrison. Nice duck out by Ted Norris. Of course, Ted Norris, a former judo instructor, a black belt karate. He holds a third degree black belt in judo, taekwondo, and kung fu. Both men. And, whoa, a nice takedown by Ted Norris. And another takedown by Ted Norris. And oh, and a good takedown by Ted Norris, and he has him in an armbar. This Ted Norris, an extremely agile competitor, and of course, Bounty number one, as you can see, is a tremendous-sized individual, a massive man, close to 300 pounds. Extremely tough competitor indeed. Ooh, and a rough hit there by Bounty Hunter number one. This Bounty Hunter apparently has no regard for the rules whatsoever. And another good takedown by Ted Norris. And Ted Norris and Mr. B outside the ring complaining to the referee. Ted Norris now has a side headlock on Bounty Hunter number one. Of course, these Bounty Hunters part of a tag team combination managed by Mr. B. Extremely controversial tag team combination. They've won several titles around the country. They have been literally all over the country, including Canada, New Zealand, France, Germany, and Africa. Side headlock still being applied by Ted Norris. And Ted Norris, and he knocked. Wow, Ted Norris showing certainly that he has the agility to go in there against the man that outweighs him by close to 75 pounds. This Ted Norris, extremely confident competitor, very, very quick. There you see, of course, the Bounty Hunter rather upset. He is upset at the fact that he has not been able to do anything so far with Ted Norris. Of course, there you're talking about, there you see Mr. B conferring with Bounty Hunter number one. Of course, this Mr. B adds a, you might say, a third dimension to the match. Of course, anybody who's sitting outside the ring in a management capacity certainly has to be looked out for. Mr. B, certainly a controversial individual indeed, and it appears that what he said to the Bounty Hunter did take some effect. Bounty Hunter now has an arm bar on Ted Norris. And, oh, and it appeared that the Bounty Hunter used the tights to pull Ted Norris down. Of course, once again, Mr. B encouraging the Bounty Hunter. And a good takedown by Ted Norris. A fine takedown. Ted Norris, of course, with an arm bar now on the Bounty Hunter. And back into the ropes. referee calling for the break, and ooh, I say that this bounty hunter certainly does not live too much by the rules and regulations. The count of three. And referee Rocky Montana warning the bounty hunter. Here you hear Mr. B in the background encouraging the bounty hunter. Ooh, and a knee right to the stomach of Ted Morris. And Ted Norris retaliating against the bounty hunter, and the bounty hunter's clawed across the eyes of Ted Norris into the turnbuckles. And apparently the referee warning Mr. B and about something. They couldn't tell from this angle. Of course, once again, there you see the bounty hunter up on top of the turnbuckle. Count of three by the referee. Ooh, and a hard kick right to the knee of Ted Norris. A kick to the back. And Ted Norris coming back. Ted Norris coming back with his karate. As we said earlier, Ted Norris is a master of Taekwondo and Kung Fu, and he is certainly coming back right now. And once again, the bounty hunter takes the upper hand. And a full body slam by the bounty hunter on Ted Norris. Ooh, and right across the eyes, the bounty hunter clawed Ted Norris right across the eyes. And indeed, there you hear again Mr. B. We certainly hope that later in the program we'll get a chance to talk to this Mr. B. And a chokehold being applied now by the bounty hunter on Ted Norris. The referee warning him. And once again, failing to relinquish that chokehold until the very last second. A highly illegal tactic, but there again, this is what makes the bounty hunters as tough as they are. Whoa-ho-ho! And Ted Norris, a drop kick by Ted Norris, and he's got the bounty hunter staggered. Outside headlock. And a nice takedown by Ted Norris. Mr. B, of course, trying to encourage the bounty hunter, giving him instructions from the side of the ring. A takedown by the bounty hunter. And once again, into the ropes. Of course, both men a test of strength at this time. Oh, and right across the eyes. And a kick by Ted Norris coming right back. This Ted Norris, of course, applying a part of professional wrestling and taekwondo and judo and what have you. And there, of course, you see the manager, Mr. B. And both men. And it appears from the angle here that Mr. B is interfering into the match to some degree. Yes, he is. He is trying to pull the trunks of Ted Norris. Arguing with the referee. Ooh, and some hard karate chops. And karate chops. And a kick to the neck by Ted Norris on the bounty hunter. He's down. One. And the bounty hunter pulls out. Of course, the bounty hunter back for more instructions from Mr. B. This, needless to say, this adds a dimension, as we once said. This is a psychological advantage against Ted Norris. The man is wrestling one man and trying to keep an eye on another. And an elbow to the back of the neck of Norris. Norris has the bounty hunter in a side headlock against the ropes. Ooh, wow. And Ted Norris tried to knock the bounty hunter down. Wait a minute. Apparently the bounty hunter has just been disqualified. Well, there again, the bounty hunter retaliating, but nonetheless has been disqualified in this match. And the referee, the winner of the match indeed, is Ted Norris via disqualification. And right with... Indeed, and of course, the winner was the bounty hunter. And right now, we're going to take the opportunity to talk to a very talented wrestler indeed, a man that I've watched wrestle for many times, and I'm referring, of course, to Ted Norris. And Ted, welcome to the program.
Well, thank you very much, Ken. It's a pleasure to be here.
Ted, you know, you're an instructor, we understand, of Taekwondo and Kung Fu and Judo. How do you compare that against what you do in the ring today?
Well, there are two conflicting styles, I believe, in karate and against wrestling. I feel professional wrestling, it's a whole different ball game in a way of training and so forth. But in the judo and the karate are certain things that we can use in professional wrestling. One of the things that I'm very worried about in professional wrestling when some martial artists come to it is that they tend to take the martial art and take shortcuts in the rule book. I don't feel that should be done. I feel the only time that I will resort to using martial arts is when I have to, when the guy is bending the rules and breaking the rules. That's my only recourse to protect myself. I would just like to make one comment if I could. I know Chuck Dempsey was out here, and he's also acclaimed to be a martial artist. I feel a true martial artist would not take shortcuts like that in the ring. I also feel that I would like to get a match with Chuck if I could, and just let the rule books go. If he wants to use the martial arts, I'll use it with him.
Well, that certainly seems interesting indeed. That's a match I wouldn't mind seeing myself, of course. And it is true, Chuck Dempsey is professed to be an expert at the martial arts, but I sincerely feel the man sitting next to me is certainly much more qualified. And Ted, it's an interesting thing to note in judo, though. Do you have any words for the younger kids who might be starting out, what to look for or something?
Just briefly, I started out when I was 6 years old, and I had a very good instructor. My father was a black belt in judo, and he started me when I was 6 years old. And stay with it. It's one of the best martial arts to start in judo or karate, any of the martial arts, and for sure it's just a good discipline. It helps kids grow up.
Well, indeed it does, and thank you so very much for being on the program.
Well, thank you, Ken.
Ted Norris, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll be back in just a moment. I'm Ken Bradley, and welcome once again to All-Star Professional Wrestling. Indeed, a very exciting hour in store for us today. We're going to be seeing the Bounty Hunters in action again today, managed, of course, by Mr. B. He'll be going up against Mike Prather and Abner Collins. We're going to have Eddie Colt here, of course, the younger brother of Mitch Colt. He'll be going up against Chuck Dempsey and a host of other wrestlers and a lot of action, so stay tuned with us today. We're going to also be talking with the Assassins a little later on in the program, and that should prove to be very, very interesting indeed. But seated right next to me at this time is a man who certainly needs no introduction to professional wrestling anywhere in the country, and I'm referring, of course, to Ted Norris. And Ted, welcome once again.
Well, thank you again, Ken. It's a pleasure to be back.
Ted, I understand that you are going very, very shortly to a karate tournament out in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Yes, we have a world tournament coming up, and it's going to combine wrestling and also combine karate and judo. Actually, it's a martial art tournament that's going to be in Las Vegas, and I hope to participate in that once more.
Well, there again, I'd like for you, we have a lot of members of the Boys Club here in the studio with us today, and you might want to go over what the difference is between the martial arts and professional wrestling per se.
Well, the basic difference between the martial arts and professional wrestling, of course, is more grappling techniques and techniques that you would use in throwing weight around are more or less just contact, more contact. With karate and so forth, there's a lot more to it. It's a lot more than just punching, kicking, and so forth. There's a lot of philosophy to it, too. Professional wrestling is more combative. It is just a combative sport, where in the martial arts, we tend to use a little bit of Tai Chi, a little bit of using your mind over matter, so forth. There's a lot more in the teachings than just in being able to get in professional wrestling, where knocking out with somebody, knocking
right.
Heads.
Right. Well, Ted, how long have you been a martial arts instructor?
Well, I've been instructing for approximately about 10 to 15 years. And I've been actually in the martial arts ever since I was 6 years old. This marks my 25th year in the martial arts.
I understand you're a second-generation martial artist.
Yes, I am. My father was a black belt in judo, and he's also instructor for the Navy. Mm-hmm. And he's one that started me out in the martial arts.
Ted, I've been meaning to ask you, since you've been down on All-Star Wrestling, how do you view the competition here versus other parts of the country?
Well, they're bringing people from all over the country and all over the world here to All-Star Professional Wrestling, and the competition just can't be beat. It's something that the fans are going to enjoy, and I look forward to each time that I'm invited to come down here to see who's going to be coming down to wrestle, because it's a surprise. There's some really good people coming down.
Well, indeed it is, and certainly I have to give a lot of credit to Mr. L.G. Howard, the president of All-Star Wrestling.
Oh,
he has
true.
Done just an outstanding job in bringing just tremendous competition down here on the program, and of course live-action matches throughout. And we understand here, as a matter of fact, I was handed a note here right before we came on the air stating about some of the people that we're going to have be coming in, and believe it or not, we're going to have the Sheik coming in, and I'm sure that you're certainly well aware of him. We're going to be having Bobo Brazil, Jerry Oates, Crazy Luke Graham, the return of Dr. Jerry Graham, the world-famous Valiant Brothers, and just many, many more. And so, indeed, in the upcoming weeks, we're certainly going to be having some extremely good competition here on All-Star Wrestling. But right now, I see it's time for our first match, so let's go into the ring with our ring announcer, Mark Craig.
This match will be the time limit. From Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 225 pounds, Ted Norris. His opponent, from parts unknown, weighing in at 220 pounds, the ex-con. The referee is Rocky Montana.
Well, there you have it. Ted Norris on the left of your screen in the black trunks, going up against the ex-con. Of course, Ted Norris himself, a fantastic competitor, a third-degree black belt martial arts instructor. Wow. Of course, this ex-con, we know very little about this man. He remains rather anonymous. Ooh, good breakout by Ted Norris. Of course, Ted Norris, very popular with the fans here. Collar and elbow as the con up against the ropes. Referee calls for the break. Nice fireman carry takedown by Ted Norris. Into an arm bar. Ooh. And right now, of course, the ex-con has the upper advantage on Ted Norris. Of course, Ted Norris, a very game competitor in both professional wrestling and karate. Very quick. Of course, a second-generation karate expert, his father also being a martial arts instructor. Let's see a good shot of the ex-con there. For six, ex-con, very, very controversial man. Very rugged competitor. We don't know his weight. We don't know where he comes from. But we do know that he has little regard for the rules and regulations of professional wrestling. Quite evident right there. Wow. Ted Norris has the ex-con totally tied up. And the ex-con puts Ted Norris into a hammerlock. Yeah, give it to him. Of course, both men seem to be equal in size. Nice. Both men seem to be about the same height and weight. The ex-con arguing with the referee, saying that he had the back of his mask pulled. It didn't appear that way from this angle. Yeah. Of course, it appears that the ex-con has a lot of respect for Ted Norris. Can't say that I blame him. And once again, the ex-con backs out. Oh, and caught Ted Norris off guard with that. Once again, into the leg lock. Ted Norris apparently had to break the hold. The ex-con had his foot over the rope. Here the crowd here in the studio booing the ex-con. Good crowd here today. Had about 300 people outside the studio waiting to get in, but unfortunately could not. Studio very limited in size here. We just don't have the capacity for a bigger crowd, but right now it's practically standing room only. Nice takedown by the ex-con on Ted Norris. Oh, and look at this. That is a version of the figure four. And the ex-con manages once again to escape. That could have very well been a submission hold. And the ex-con, of course, trying to take all the time that he can. Managed to break away from a submission hold. That's very painful. That figure four leg lock and variations thereof are extremely painful, very, very hard on the knees. An arm bar on the ex-con. Oh, wow, and a double. And apparently Ted Norris there showing a little bit of that karate expertise. Well, once again, the ex-con complaining to referee Rocky Montana. Oh, a very frustrated Ted Norris right now. He wants to get the action on, and the ex-con apparently is stalling. Of course, very possibly the ex-con feels that he'd rather run the time limit out than at least be accredited with a draw rather than a loss, possibly. Whoa, and look at that, right over the top rope. And apparently Ted Norris still holding on to the leg of the ex-con. Now the referee apparently telling the ex-con that he jumped over the top rope. I don't know, the angle here on the monitor was a little difficult to tell. I think the ex-con was trying to call for Ted Norris's disqualification there, saying that he was thrown over the top rope. This ex-con appears that he wants no part of Ted Norris. None whatsoever. And Ted Norris is telling the ex-con, let's get it on, let's go. Can't say that I blame him. Ted Norris had a lot of momentum going. And the ex-con stalling for time. Wow. It appeared as though he ripped the eyes of Ted Norris. Oh, hard left hand right to the throat of Ted Norris by the ex-con. Norris a little bit dazed by that, trying to shake out the cobwebs. Side headlock applied by Ted Norris. Nice takedown. Ted Norris maintaining that headlock on the ex-con. Wow, and Ted Norris retaliating on the ex-con. It's Ted Norris, such a game competitor. Oh, and it appears right in the eyes of Ted Norris. Right in the eyes, the ex-con continuing to deal out punishment to Ted Norris. He's got him in a full Nelson. Wait a minute! Oh, for heaven's sakes! Chuck Dempsey interfered into the match. He went to give him a karate thrust to the throat. He missed and hit the ex-con. One, two, three, that's it! That is it! Well, obviously, Chuck Dempsey, who tried to make good for the ex-con, it backfired. And as a result, the winner of the match, Ted Norris. Well, sometimes you once see the cheating just certainly does not pay off, and it certainly didn't in that case there. But our congratulations to a...
This match will be a tag team match. One fall with a 15-minute time limit. Weighing in at 235 pounds from Las Vegas, Nevada, Ted Norris. His partner, weighing in at 222 pounds from Chicago, Illinois, Angelo Poffo. Their opponent, weighing in at 295 pounds from New York City, Crazy Luke Graham. His partner, weighing in at 240 pounds from Tampa, Florida, the Continental Lover, Eddie Mansfield.
Well, there you have it. Eddie Mansfield and Luke Graham going up against Ted Norris and Angelo Poffo. And frankly, Abner, I'll tell you, this is a main event anywhere in the country.
Oh, yes. These are international stars, four international stars in the ring here. Come from all corners of the earth to meet together.
Well, indeed they do. Of course, Angelo Poffo, what can you say about this man? He's held many titles throughout the world. Interestingly enough, he's in Ripley's, believe it or not, is doing 6,033 consecutive sit-ups. I find that amazing.
Ripley, I believe it's in the Guinness Book of Records, and it still stands to this day. 6,000 sit-ups.
I believe you're correct. There you see Poffo being tied up in the turnbuckle by Eddie Mansfield. Of course, this Mansfield-Luke Graham combination, Abner, extremely rugged indeed. Luke Graham up for, appears to be a full body slam. Wow.
He just threw him across the ring. He threw him across the ring.
Luke Graham just threw Angelo Poffo across the ring. Tags out with Eddie Mansfield. Of course, Mansfield, one of the most sought-after wrestlers in the country today. A very celebrated athlete. Two-year ball player for the Oakland A's. And Poffo tags out to Ted Norris. And Ted Norris, he's fired up going up against Mansfield.
But Mansfield has some respect for the karate's.
Well, I would think he should have. Norris in that side headlock takedown. Mansfield wiggles out. Of course, here you have, like I say, Abner, this is a main event anywhere in the country. Promoters would literally pay thousands for this match right here. Oh, wow. And there you see interference by Luke Graham.
Luke Graham, yeah, it's a punch to the throat. There, he retaliates back.
And Luke Graham interfering on the outside. Of course, I must admit, Abner, that Mansfield and Luke Graham, certainly an awesome tag team combination.
Oh, yeah, they're like a synchronized machine. They constantly wear you down, constantly beat on you. You don't get a chance to take a break until you escape. One of the mistakes I made when I had a match was I got stuck in that corner like this under the circumstance.
Well, it's true, and I'm glad you had the opportunity to be with me today, Abner, to lend your expertise, because I know last week you were defeated at the hands of Mansfield and Luke Graham.
Yes, that was that controversy thumb that Luke Graham
indeed
put in my partner's throat.
Yes, it was indeed. The crowd beginning to pick up the chant.
You see, this Luke Graham is massive. Boy, he must stand 6'6" and probably 325 pounds.
Well, he states that he is 295 pounds indeed, and a very rugged individual, of course, a wealth of experience. Mansfield continues to deal out punishment to Ted Norris. Mansfield tagging out to Luke Graham. Ooh, there you see that double team effort again. Of course, it's tactics like this that are most controversial indeed, but nonetheless, it's what takes him to the top.
I said, you can see that Ted trying to get out of that corner. He's being held in there by Mansfield, and he's got him biting on his fingers, that's what.
Indeed, Ted Norris, apparently it appears that the Mansfield was biting Ted Norris. It's hard to tell from this angle. And Norris coming back with those judo kicks to the face of Luke Graham, tags off Angelo Poffo. Poffo in the ring now against Luke Graham.
Hit him up. Right hand to the jaw, another right to the jaw.
Right now, Poffo throws
over
Graham
the arm. Oh, the ring almost fell off. There's a big arm whip to the corner.
You can see the ring shaking. That Luke Graham, a massive man. Poffo dealing a little punishment to Eddie Mansfield.
Hit him out. Whoa.
Oh, you could have heard that clean across the studio. Arm whips, Luke Graham.
Oh, big backdrop. Oh,
indeed it was.
This could be it,
nice
Ken. This could be,
oh. And Luke Graham immediately powers out, leaves the ring. And Mansfield looks a little hesitant to step into the ring against Poffo. Of course, I can't say that I blame him.
Well, now that Angelo's cleaned house, there's a little more respect than there's.
He certainly is indeed.
There he goes. Take advantage now.
Nice takedown by Angelo Poffo. Tags out with Ted Norris. Ted Norris maintaining that leg scissors on Eddie Mansfield. Of course, this Ted Norris is a super competitor in his own right. He's a martial arts instructor, third degree black belt. It's an interesting man to talk to. He really is. He's been all over the country.
Yes, I've had Ted as my partner a few times, and he kind of recommends highly, in my estimation, as a partner for anybody. And he's one I'm considering that I'm looking at.
And looks apparently like Mansfield's getting a little of his own medicine here. He's tied up the rope. Oh,
there
wow!
They've got him set up now. They can continue to work on him.
Apparently, Mansfield falling victim to a little double teaming.
Norris got Mansfield in a headlock there.
Of course, Norris and Poffo, a very, very rugged combination.
If he can maintain that squeeze on the jugular vein, slowing the blood down to his brain, he can get him out in the knockout and the sleeper. It could be worked to a combination of a sleeper and maybe put Mansfield out.
Of course, Mansfield attempted a tag out. Whoa, wait a minute.
Behind him.
Little outside interference there by Luke Graham. That almost appeared to be an illegal tag there, Abner.
I believe it was, because he was already half in the ring with one foot.
High knee lift right to the face of Ted Norris. Oh, now this is painful.
By the hair, this is illegal.
Front face lock being applied by Luke Graham.
Ted
and Ted Norris escapes nicely and applies a hammerlock to Luke Graham.
Very good sit out into the hammerlock.
Hammerlock into a leg hold. Of course, you can see there that controversial bandage that Luke Graham seems to wear on that thumb. I see no reason for it.
Yeah, there hasn't been any legitimate explanation for the bandage. And questionable if there's something in there also. Ted Norris still maintaining the hammerlock.
Of course, Norris giving away considerable size and weight to Luke Graham. Norris around 235. Tags out with Angelo Poffo. Wow. I'll tell you, this Poffo, he's just been around for so many years. And what you're seeing here, Abner, is sheer experience against experience. And look at that.
Oh, skull crush. Two headbutts. Oh, skull crush is there.
Poffo is simply running Luke Graham's head right into that of Eddie Mansfield. It appears that Poffo now...
But there's a question. That Mansfield is holding him in the corner from behind. While Luke Graham is...
It does appear that way, that Mansfield is definitely interfering. Of course, Mansfield now coming into the ring, tagging out with Graham.
Continue the punching there.
Certainly keeping Poffo tied up in the turnbuckle. Of course, this seems to be a favorite ploy of Mansfield. He tries to get an opponent tied up in the opposite part of the ring,
right,
keep him from tagging out. And an arm whip.
There we go, into the corner.
I tell you, that didn't work. And there you see Mansfield still laying in the corner. Poffo tagging out to Ted Norris, and Norris wanting Mansfield to get off the canvas. I'll tell you, Ted Norris unleashing some hard blows to the head of Eddie Mansfield.
Went for the drop. Went for the drop kick, and Mansfield held the ropes.
Yes, he did. Mansfield got out of the way just in time, and Norris came crashing down on his left arm. And head right into the turnbuckle. Tag out with Luke Graham. Of course, both of these men issuing punishment to Ted Norris.
Oh, wow. It's a right hand right to the jaw, right straight to the jaw.
Oh, I'll tell you. Well, I'll tell you, make no bones about it, Abner. This Mansfield-Graham combination is a record one indeed. And there you see Ted Norris still tied up in the turnbuckles.
Ted, now he's you can absorb a lot of punishment in there. Ted Norris is amazingly recovery.
Arm whips Norris into the ropes.
Oh! Hang.
Wow, and that clothesline, I'll tell you, that clothesline won.
He pulled him up. There's no need for that. If the man was down and beat, he should have stayed and pinned him. There's no need to.
Certainly is not.
Just inflicting extra
like
punishment.
That. And apparently, Ted Norris got over to tag out with Angelo Poffo. Now Poffo retaliating against Eddie Mansfield. Wait a minute.
What's that Luke Graham over there doing something to Ted Norris?
Luke Graham using that controversial thumb again right to the throat. And Angelo Poffo issuing medicine out to both men. Luke Graham into the ring going up against Ted Norris. Oh!
That's that thumb again.
That is two, three. Well, that's it. That controversial thumb. Needless to say, a very controversial thing indeed, Abner.
Yes, it was. Just prior to him entering the ring, he went over there and snuck behind Norris and jammed that thumb. You can see it from
that way. But what can we say? Nonetheless, the winners of the match are Eddie Mansfield and Luke Graham. And we'll be right back.
We now will proceed with an exhibition by Ted Norris. And Ted would like to tell us about what he's about to do.
The first thing I'm going to do is a little warm-up with the nunchakos. Now, these are Chinese fighting weapons. Many people have probably seen them on TV and so forth. I'll just do a brief exercise with these, and then I'll go on and do some more things. thing I'm going to demonstrate is a forward punch to a break and also using the elbow, showing that we have different weapons that we use in karate to maximum effective use. Now we're going to demonstrate the other powers that we use in karate, and that is, of course, our feet. I'll be demonstrating a front snap kick combined with the side kick.
I must agree. This Ted Norris, of course, such a tremendous competitor, and you can certainly understand why he's going up to the top. Of course, here he's going to try to, I think, break some boards with his feet. He did not do it. He did that time.
Very good.
Wow, beautiful.
Very good. Beautiful. Very well done. Absolutely. Very well done.
Stunning.
Which was the truth, those boards are hard. They're hard to break.
I would agree with that. Let's see what Ted Norris has planned now.
Demonstrate is a double front snap kick.
Is that what is it? Is it what's happening?
Now wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, for heaven's sakes!
Look,
oh,
you see
goodness
what I'm saying?
You see what I'm saying? Dempsey just came into the ring.
What can I tell you, Ken? Hell of an exhibition. I've never seen a man break a board with his head like that before.
Right. And you think you're hot, don't you?
Oh, I do.
And you
not
think you're something?
This.
Hitting a man from behind off the top rope.
I certainly do not believe this at all. Ted Norris in the ring here in front of the youngsters. The boys' club came down to the studio today. You can see there Ted Norris down on the mat. Hit severely by Chuck Dempsey right over the head with one of those boards. And I'll tell you, that, well, there you see the ring announcer, Danny Roberts, and the referees trying to aid Ted Norris out of the ring. Well, you know, Pac-Man, I'll tell you, that is entirely uncalled for.
Can I say something right now?
Yes,
to you
indeed.
Fans who saw this, if you want this kind of thing stopped, and I think you do like I do, write in your letters to the crusade, Pac-Man's crusade, join Pac-Man's army. Stop this kind of thing. You can do it. You people can do it.
Well, yes, indeed, they certainly can. And Pac-Man, I think that was an utter disgrace on the part of Chuck Dempsey. We certainly hope that Ted Norris is all right, but nonetheless, we can't help but feel that Chuck Dempsey will definitely pay his dues.
It's up to you people. You send in your letters, you stop this sort of thing. You're the ones that can do it. All of you, send in your letters, write. Let him show that we really mean business.
Indeed.
Unbelievable. Just unbelievable. A thing like that should happen.
We'll
I don't know what's
right
happening
back
to wrestling.
The match will be one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Weighing in at 260 pounds from Jacksonville, Florida, Mike Prather. His opponent, weighing in at 205 pounds from Vancouver, British Columbia, Chuck Dempsey.
Well, there you have it. Iron Mike Prather going up against Chuck Dempsey. Of course, I still can't help but feel when I look at this Dempsey, I still can't believe what he did earlier in the program during that karate demonstration with Ted Norris. Absolutely incomprehensible. Oh, wow. Of course, Chuck Dempsey professes to be a master of kung fu himself. Mike Prather, they call him the Iron Man out of Jacksonville, Florida. A very rugged competitor. Mike Prather lifts Dempsey up for a full body slam. Oh, wow, and Prather brings the back of that leg across Chuck Dempsey's neck. And a shoulder right to the midsection of Chuck Dempsey. A very nice move by Mike Prather. Nice takedown. I tell you, like we say, Mike Prather used to try it out for football at one time. Dempsey continuing to issue punishment to Mike Prather. And Dempsey on top of Mike Prather. Unbelievable man, this time. Now, wait a minute. Hold it. Wait a minute. Ted Norris. Ted Norris into the ring. Oh, my goodness. And Ted Norris comes in, and he's retaliating with that chair. Retaliating, I'll tell you. I don't know what to make of this, but he's getting back at what Chuck Dempsey did to him earlier. Ted Norris in there, he's issuing punishment. I tell you, our time is just about gone here. We'll have to bring you up to date next week on exactly what happened. We have mayhem. We'll see you next week. Everybody, I'm Ken Bradley, and welcome once again to All-Star Professional Wrestling. Indeed, a very exciting hour ahead of us. But right now, joining me here at the table, Ted Norris, the Nevada Karate Wrestling Champion. And frankly, Ted, after the incident that happened last week, it is just unbelievable to me that you're still up and walking around.
Well, I'm very lucky to be here.
Well, indeed, that's
the truth. We took the bandages off this morning. Ken, I want to apologize for last week for when I came back into the ring at the... toward the end of the taping of the show. I had an injury to my head, and I just really lost control. And I apologize for that. I did that in front of a lot of kids, a lot of fans, and I feel responsible about that. And if I can, Ken, what I'd like to say is, at this time, I have signed the contract with Mr. L.G. Howard to meet Chuck Dempsey anywhere, any arena, any place in this country. And I'm going to put up the belt that I won in Las Vegas, which is the Western World Martial Art Wrestling Championship belt. That's on the line. And I want to meet Mr. Dempsey. I've had enough of it. I'm not going to let him interfere with a match, my match, or anybody's match anymore. That's it. It's over.
Well, there you have it, the comments of Ted Norris. And frankly, Ted, I must say, it's my understanding as of this time that Chuck Dempsey is very reluctant to countersign this contract.
He's squabbling about money. I've already signed the bottom line. To me right now, money isn't the factor.
Well,
to him, he wants a lot more than that I'm getting from the first. But what I want is him. That's all I want.
Well, indeed. Needless to say, though, this man is a dangerous adversary, Ted. I've seen him wrestle many times. You've encountered with him before. It will definitely be, when you get right down to it, a life and death situation in the ring.
I feel it's going to have to be that way. I'm not going to have it any other way. I'll try with the rule book with him, but if he breaks the rule book, I'll break the rule book.
I'd like
to break it over him.
Well, there you have the comments of Ted Norris. I see it's time for our first match, so let's go into the ring with our ring announcer, Steve Wortham. Dressed in black.
We ask that all children please stand to the ring opener. Pitchers, you can come up, but please stay away from the bear because he has that harness if he wanted to. So we're going to do a tag team. Please make sure everybody stands back. No.
Bear took one look at Ted, and Bear jumped out of the ring.
Stupid.
Bear no dummy.
Oh, he's stubborn, huh?
They had the ropes loose.
He wanted out.
Where you're sitting, it may not look like it. But I'm gonna tell you, the bear is scared to death.
Better you than me, Ted. Oh, that looks like a pig. Thank you.
There's an arm bar.
Into some kind of problem, please make sure you stand back. 30 miles an hour that bear can run short distance, and those are real teeth.
Because if he goes after me, I'm going to give it
to him. Anywhere it won't fit. That's right. Anywhere he wants to.
Thank you.
here on Skype.
I don't know why. It's the left.
Thank you.
and Danny Roberts as they're making their way to the ring. What's the cameraman do? Fall down? Oh, somebody shot. Okay, okay, fine.
Match, so let's turn it over to our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your special mixed tag team match. This special matchup.
Thank you. Upside Come on, Dad! Right now, this is a woman named Carolyn who is now 46 years old. Carolyn says she was teased and picked on back then because of her looks, but she says with her family on welfare, there weren't a whole lot of things that she could do to improve her appearance. Now, at the age of 46, Carolyn says she has everything she wants in life, including a chance to reunite with a former best friend she hasn't seen in 33 years. That's going to happen in just a minute. First, let's meet her. Here is Carolyn. It's a 46-year-old body we're looking at here.
Homecoming queen, 71, eat my dust.
Man, you look at... This is you're a major success story. Very rough childhood again, right?
Yes, I learned very easy that life... I'm very early that life wasn't going to be very easy. I came up with six children in my family. I was the oldest of six.
On welfare. Food stamps.
We had the hand-me-down clothes and... Not very much. Christmas was when welfare came by with big boxes or bags of presents that said girl, boy, and they separated them for us. That was Christmas. We had, when I was 8 years old, four of us were old enough to go into a children's home, and we didn't even get to see each other when we were on the campus there. We lived there for 4 years. Times when...
Because there was no money?
My mother and my father were separated, and she couldn't support all six of us. Four of us went in the children's home, and two of them... After a period of time with her working 24 hours a day almost, she decided it would be better for the two youngest ones, who were one and two.
You were teased a lot, right?
I was teased an awful lot. They called me olive oil. They called me pizza face. They told me not to turn sideways or I wouldn't be seen. I was taller than everybody else in my class.
And skinny, I guess, right?
And skinny, yeah. And flat-chested. Okay. Pirate's treasure was a buried chest. You know that kind of thing. I got that all my life.
And this girl, Janice, you haven't
Janice
seen
Janice won't have a clue.
She hasn't seen you in 33 years.
33 years. She'll remember me as... The shy one.
Oh, yeah, that's exactly what she said. Why don't you go backstage for a minute? We're going to hide you while we talk to her. Well, Carolyn's former classmate, Janice, says she does remember Carolyn as being very quiet, very shy, very reserved. She figures Carolyn's probably the same person she was in junior high school, only older. Well, she's in for a surprise. Here's Janice, everybody.
Hi, Jenny.
You have not seen Carolyn in 33 years.
33 years.
She looks a lot different than the last time you remember her.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah. Did you hear the audience when she got up and walked off?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, well, there was a reason for that. Tell us how you remember her back then.
I remember her being very thin, boyish-like, very timid.
Parts of her are still thin.
Very, very thin. Just a sweet person, very timid, kind of introvert.
It's been 33 years. This is the way you may remember her looking back then.
Oh, my, yes.
But this is the way she looks now. Carolyn! How does she look? I bet you could walk down the street past her and wouldn't have even known who this was.
Oh, no, never.
What's the biggest change?
This is not the person I remember.
What's the biggest difference?
Well, I think I got rid of those and she got them.
I drank a lot of milk when I was growing up.
I know it's a big reunion after that many years, but what do you want to say to her, Carolyn?
I tell you what, she stood by me and loved me. When I thought I was ugly, she always thought that I was pretty, and she supported me. I had a a death in my family, everything that happened, there were so many bad things going on then, and she was always there for me. She was my sister. We were inseparable then.
Oh.
You know, we were very,
she
very
wanted
close.
To bring you on television and say thanks.
Oh,
that's really sweet. All right, we'll take a break when we come back. Kids teased her because she wore the same clothes to school every single day. Now she's so successful, she never has to wear the same outfit twice. Here's some more music.
The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. Seaweed's always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea. Under the sea, darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we've been boating, push out to floating under the sea. Wonder if the fish is happy as I feel the river. The fish on the land ain't happy. It's hard to stay in the bowl, but fish in the bowl is lucky. They in for a worse update. One day when the boss gets hungry, the soup will be on the plate. Oh, under the sea, nobody beat us, lawyers and eat in fricassee. We watch the land, folks loves to cook. Under the sea, we have to hook up. We got no troubles. Life is the bubbles under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea. Seems like it's sweeter. We got to be here naturally. Even the sturgeon and the whale, they did the earth start to play. We got the spirit. You got the spirit. Under the sea. The top, play the hop, the play, play the bass, and they sound the chop, the bass, play the brass, the tub, play the tom, the flute is the root of soul. The lady can play the lead on the strings, the top, acting out the black face, the thing, the belt and the butt, they know where it's at, they know that bluff is blow.
Yeah.
clown here, no hyper down here.
Under the sea.
This little slug here, that thing around here.
Under the sea.
This little snail here, no hyper whale here. That's why it's on the under the water. Yeah, we love here, down here, down here, down here.
Under the sea.
Fishing on a sandy beach, cast my line out as far as it would reach, looking for something for the frying pan. I kicked back with a beer in my hand. I must have got a big one cause it's bending my pole. I'm having a fight just to keep control. It could be a whale, God only knows. Whatever it is, it's not wearing any clothes. Larger than life, made from holy water. She's covered in green and got little scales upon her. She's larger than life. She's a mermaid tonight. She's got a set of gills like no fish I've ever seen. Long blonde hair and a tail in between. I'm in love with the creature from the sea. She brings out the crustacean in me. Her voice is a temptation, it's a siren song. When we kiss, there can be no wrong. I ask her to marry me and be my wife.